Alright, so first, I'm gonna ruin paper and pencil. And I'm gonna tell you why in just a minute. And if you guys wanna use pen, that is completely fine. I like pen better anyway, but but if you, yeah. Probably not really, but
yeah. That's nice.
Like it. Mm-hmm. Alright, so I have a question for you guys. Show of hands for all those who believe that they can draw. Mm-hmm. Maybe you'd say you can draw, yeah?
I need a reference.
Okay. Alright, that's good. Because, well, today I'd like to prove to everyone that everyone can draw. Now, I'm not saying that you're going to walk out of here like Michelangelo. Leonardo da Vinci, but I can prove to you that you'll be able to draw things like cartoon characters' faces like this. Different examples, yeah? So, I'm gonna redo the face that I just did. So first, we have just like a nose. It's kind of like, I don't know, like just sideways. And then you have two 66s here, a big smile, an ear, hair, and then you're gonna put the pen to the left of the mouth, drop it down, under the ear, down, around the neck, one to the left, one to the right. And so we're gonna start a toolbox over here. So first we have eyes. And so as of right now, we have these eyes that are like 66s. We have a nose that is just like a little bump there. Ears, we have is that little line, and mouth, we have this one, yeah. And so now let's go for another example. So start off with the nose, it's a little triangle, two eyes, can give two little dots. Little triangle over there. Gonna fill in the bottom part like that. And give her some hair. Into the left of the mouth and down, under the hair, around the neck, onto the left, onto the right. Alright, so we have our toolbox here again. Time to follow along and we'll see what kind of characters that you can draw. Yeah? So we're gonna start out with this guy and he's gonna have glasses. So you're gonna have two frames here, yeah? He's have two little dots for the eyes in the middle there. And the nose like that. Yeah. And then we'll add a mustache. We'll add an ear over here. Like that. Make a bow. And then, is that talking? Then we'll add a finish like that. Yeah. glasses. And we have, that's the same nose as that one. We have the same ear. In the mouth, we have a mustache. No hair. Alright. Now I want you guys to follow along as we make another cartoon character, yeah? So, and this is somebody that you all will probably recognize, yeah? So we'll start off with a nose, similar to what we did before, yeah? Okay. And same thing we're gonna do, some 66s, just like on the first one, yeah? Mustache on him. Alright, now we're gonna add some crazy hair. Now we're gonna draw it to the neck, just under the mustache, down, one like that. And under the hair, we'll draw, yeah, we'll draw a V shape for his shirt, then line to the left, line to the right. And you guys just grew Albert Einstein. Yeah? All right. Let's try some more along together, yeah? So let's say we want to make one a little bit more feminine, yeah? So we'll have a circle like that first. And then we're going to start from the top of the circle, go down, and connect it to the bottom. Then we're going to add some eyelids, just like that. And then we'll add the pupils in there. Some eyelashes. Now, this part, a little tricky. We're gonna add some lips. So we're gonna do a smile, just as we did before. And we're gonna draw two mountains on the top of the lips. And then another line like that on the bottom. To pencil to the left of the mouth, drop it down under the hair, kind of leave it, and the line to the left and line to the right. All right, how we're doing so far? What do you guys think?
Fun.
Yeah. They don't have to be perfect or exactly like this one because, well, differences make up the world go around, make the world go around. And so we'll add these other things to the toolbox, yeah? So we had her eyes. We had our eyes like this. Her nose. Her mouth you can practically make whatever kind of cartoon character you would like. You can have a whole bunch of different combinations like this, and they don't always have to be happy. For example, we can draw another one. You guys can take a break for now, yeah? You can have another one, a little different variation right now, and say that they're a little framed, yeah? And I'm gonna have here like the first one, change up the ear a little bit. Or you can even change it, and for example, in he's a little sick, yeah. Or let's say you want him to, you can have him be a little upset. Everyone gets upset sometimes, right? And add some curly hair. And that's just what's so fun about it, is that there's so many different variations and you can make it all your own. And so at the end of today's class, you'll be making your own cartoon character using tools from the toolbox. Yeah? And so you can use any of these that you would like. And so and what's so awesome about this is that we don't have to feel like we are limited by anything, because when you all walked into this class, you all were a little bit iffy if you could draw. But after looking and drawing these cartoons, you guys can be sure that, yeah, you can draw. Maybe it's not going to be something like Leonardo da Vinci, but you guys are drawing cartoons, you guys are drawing something that is recognizable to other people as being a human face. So, I want everyone on their own to draw their own cartoon character. After you're done, you're gonna turn to your partner and people around you, and say one thing that you like about theirs, and you're also gonna say one thing that you like about your own. feeling good? This is about good. When you're finished, just turn to the people around you and say one thing you like about their drawing and something that you like about your own. It turned out well. It's exactly what we were doing, so yeah. So how do y'all feel like each one of you can draw? Yeah. Because like I said before, you can use all of these things to create hundreds and thousands of cartoons. If you want, you can even start your own comic strip. You know? I'm just really happy that I can teach things like this because, you don't have to limit yourself to what you can do. And all these ideas that, you know, maybe we can't draw, maybe we can't sing, all these different things are just things that we have told ourselves or someone else has told us. But as we keep on trying and we keep on practicing even like the simplest things, we can learn how to do great things. We don't have to be limited by what we say to ourselves and what anyone